Alright guys, welcome back to my Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets Let's Play. Last video, we went and interrogated Malfoy about whether or not he was the heir of Slytherin. Now, and we went to Myrtle's bathroom and found Tom Riddle's diary. And he told us about it being Hagrid releasing, or supposedly releasing the monster within the chamber last time. But to anyone who's actually watched the show, watched the movie, and read the books, we all know that's not him. So now we're going to go to Hagrid's hut and talk to him. First time we get to go into Hagrid's hut with him actually being there now.
Oh, yeah. See those little dots on the
thing? Okay.
Yeah, that one has three.
Hey.
That means,
the heck?
Three of those were right.
I wonder what this key opens.
Cool.
I suppose I should follow them.
Let's try this.
Yeah. Yay.
I'm gonna get that in the
I don't know what to do with this thing. Maybe it's just a flower. Maybe it's just there. No. Can't be. I don't know. Spider trail. Oh, we get to go find Aragog. Yay. Oh, I get to go through so many spiders. This is gonna be lovely fun.
Oh crap, we're at the very end.
To Aragog's lair we go. Hello, Aragog. Who is this? A man? Is it Hagrid? No, this is a stranger. Get rid of him. I was sleeping. I'm a friend of Hagrid. Hagrid has never sent men into our hollow before. Hagrid's in trouble, that's why I've come. In trouble? But why has he sent you? They think up at the school that Hagrid's been setting a something on students. They've taken him to Azkaban. But that was years ago. That's why they made him leave the school. They believe that I was the monster that dwells in what they call the Chamber of Secrets. They thought that Hagrid had opened the chamber and set me free. And you didn't come from the Chamber of Secrets? I was not born in the castle. I came from a distant land. Hagrid had me when I was only an egg. He cared for me, fed me table scraps. Hagrid is my good friend and a good man. When discovered and blamed for the death of a girl, he protected me, and I have lived here in the forest ever since. So you never attacked anyone. Out of respect for Hagrid, I have never harmed a human. The only part of the castle I ever saw was the cupboard in which I grew up, and the girl who was killed was discovered in a bathroom. But then, do you know what did kill the girl? Because whatever it is, it's back and attacking people again. The thing that lives in the castle is an ancient creature we spiders fear above all others. We do not speak of it. Well, I'll just go then. Go? I think not. But... I cannot deny my children fresh meat when it wanders so willingly into our midst. Goodbye, friend of Hagrid. No! Run! Hey, Carr. I wouldn't have lasted much longer if you hadn't turned up in the car. Thanks, Ron. You do the same for me. I'm afraid I've got some bad news. Your trunk's been ransacked. I don't know if anything's missing, but it's a bit of a mess up there. You'd better go check it out. Okay. Alright. Well, We're getting close. Let's go find out if anything was taken from my chest. Oh yeah, this looks like such a mess. Someone's definitely been looking for something. Oh no! Riddle's diary's gone! I better go and tell Ron and Hermione in the common room. Ray is about to fight Quirrell. Oh. Where's Ron? What? But only Gryffindor could have stolen. No one else knows our password. Hey, Ron. What's happened, Ron? Ginny. Ginny's disappeared. McGonagall said a student has been taken by the monster into the Chamber of Secrets itself. What are we going to do? Wait here. I've had an idea. Okay. Come on. Down we go again.
Well, I thought I had a view of the first magic from the game.
Hey, Ron. Well, hello, Harry. I don't know where Hermione is today. Meet me down on the second floor and we'll see if she's in Moaning Myrtle's bathroom. Yeah, this sucks. I'd go and get some stuff from Fred and George, but I don't have much reason to. You shouldn't wander around the school at night, Potter, but it's fortunate you've bumped into me. I think you'd better go to the hospital wing. There's been another attack. It's Hermione. Oh no, I don't remember what floor the hospital wing's on. I think it's the fourth floor.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Wonder if she saw the attacker. Hey, look in her right hand. What is it? I don't know. Looks like a piece of paper. It's a page torn from a book. Of the many fearsome beasts and monsters that live, that roam our land, there is none more deadly than the basilisk, known also as the King of Serpents. Its methods of killing are most wondrous, for aside from its venomous fangs, the basilisk has a murderous stare, and all who are fixed with the beam of its eye shall suffer instant death. Spiders flee before the basilisk, for it is their mortal enemy. Hermione's written the word pipes at the bottom. That's it, Ron! The monster is a basilisk, a giant snake. That's why I've been hearing voices, because I understand Parseltongue. No one's looked directly at it, so that's why no one's died, and they've only been petrified. But how's a flippin' great snake been getting around the place? Pipes, Ron. It's been using the plumbing. The entrance to the Chamber of Secrets? What if it's in a bathroom? What if it's a bathroom? I don't remember. Moaning Myrtle's bathroom. Let's go there now and see if she knows anything. Back to the second floor we go. The portraits are a magical thing on this game. I'm still missing a spell. It's kind of odd not having it. What do you want this time, Myrtle? Tell us how you died. Oh, it was dreadful. I died right in that stall. I had hidden because Olive Hornby was teasing me about my glasses. The door was locked and I was crying. And then I heard somebody come in and they said something funny, a different language, I think. Anyway, it was a boy speaking. So I unlocked the door to tell him to go and use his own bathroom, and then I died. How? No idea. I just remember seeing a pair of great big yellow eyes. Where exactly did you see the eyes? There, somewhere by that sink. Let's look. Look here, there's a tiny snake scratched into the edge of the sink. Say something in parcel tongue. Open up. That was magical. Into the chamber we go. I can't get through, Harry. You go on ahead. I'll get help. Ouch, really? How did that even hit me? Alright, guys. Well, I guess we're coming up to the end of the game. I get to fight the basilisk shortly. Ginny, please don't be dead. She won't wake up. Hello, Riddle. Tom Riddle? What do you mean, she won't wake up? She's still alive, but only just. How did Ginny get like this? The diary. My diary. Little Ginny's been writing in it for months. She poured out her soul to me, and I grew stronger and stronger on a diet of her deepest fears. Ow. Her darkest secrets. Powerful enough to start feeding her some of my secrets, to pour a little of my soul back into her. What do you mean? Ginny Weasley opened the Chamber of Secrets. She set the serpent off Slytherin on those mudbloods. Of course, she didn't know she was doing it at first. Then she grew suspicious of the diary and tried to get rid of it. But you found it, Harry. The very person I was most anxious to meet. I wanted to find out more about you, so I decided to show you my famous capture of that great oaf Hagrid to gain your trust. You framed Hagrid, didn't you? Yeah. As if he could really be capable of opening the Chamber of Secrets. He lacks the brains and the power. Only Dumbledore believed he was innocent. I bet he saw right through you. Well, he certainly kept an annoyingly close watch over me. I knew I wouldn't be able to open the chamber again while I was in school, so I preserved my 16-year-old self in the diary, hoping that one day I could lead another in my footsteps and finish Salazar Slytherin's noble work. Well, you haven't finished it! The Mandrake Drought is almost ready, and everyone who was petrified will be back to normal. Killing mudbloods isn't my concern anymore. For many months now, my new target has been... you. I knew you'd go to any lengths to solve the mystery, especially if one of your friends was attacked. So I made Ginny write her own farewell on the wall and come down here. I've been waiting for you. I have many questions for you, Harry Potter. Like what? Well, how is it that a baby with no extraordinary magical talent managed to defeat the greatest wizard of all time? How did you escape with nothing but a scar while Lord Voldemort's powers were destroyed? Why do you even care how I escaped? Voldemort was after your time. Voldemort is my past, present, and future, Harry Potter. Tom Marvolo Riddle. I am Lord Voldemort. It was a name I was already using at Hogwarts to my most intimate friends. Of course, a name wizards would one day fear to speak when I had become the greatest sorcerer in the world. To business, Harry. Twice in your past, in my future, we have met, and twice I failed to kill you. How did you survive? The longer you talk, the longer you stay alive. No one knows why you lost your powers, but I know why you couldn't kill me. Because my mother, my common, non-magical-born mother, died to save me. And I've seen the real you. I saw you last year. You're barely alive. You're ugly and disgusting. I see now. Your mother dying for you. A powerful counter-charm. There's nothing special about you after all. I wondered, because there are strange likenesses between us, Harry Potter. Now, Harry... let's match the powers of Lord Voldemort, heir of Slytherin, against famous Harry Potter. Speak to me, Slytherin, greatest of the Hogwarts Four. It's a good thing I brought Wiganwell down here. Wow, the snakes! So many of them! Ooh, they do not want to die. Alright.
That's all she wrote.
What the hell? Do I have to actually kill them all? Great. I guess I did have to kill them.
You see, Harry is still out there, Dumbledore.
Why?
Not a good Dumbledore.
Your father left with me.
Hello, basilisk. Go for the eyes, fox. Rawr! remember you. Yeah, I do remember you. Oh no, the basilisk is angry. Oh my god, this thing will not die. I'm barely doing any damage. Oh no, he's poisoned me. Ah! Oh crap. Oh, what is this? What is he doing? He's hitting, he's throwing shit at me now. Oh, his pattern changed. Very tricky. Very tricky, my friend Basilisk. Oh crap, I'm out of potion to heal. What hit me? Okay, poison, go away.
Wait a minute. No! No! Oh. No! The crap! I have 2 points below Slytherin.
I think I'm gonna lose this battle, guys.
Oh, wait. Never mind.
Holy crap, die, stupid thing! What? Yeah, it is. No, I will not die! No! No!
End of the game. Thanks for sticking around and watching. We got some really close calls at the end, but we never died once. Yeah. Look at Mortar Mortis.
And I'm dead, guys.
You get that Lucian spell. Really worked out better. Like.
Oh, sorry. I don't want to watch this again. Crap. This is probably going to be a slightly long... Oh, and I don't have any more potions. Beautiful. Do that, you stupid snake.
So, I'll go ahead and show you what happens after the game. Load your game. Start off back at fighting your wand and all the damage. Basically, get the run through the game over and over again. All your stuff, I think. And I don't know about your spells, you have to redo your spells. But other than that, pretty good. I like games that let you do that.
I didn't even touch him! Oh, well, I'm screwed.
But, yeah.
Yes, I know I'm poisoned.
Great spells, they gonna get back up in the fall. All these are flying.
Oh my god, this freaking boss. Yes, game. And my FPS is not happy with me right now. Oh my gosh.
Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed the day. You have just seen the kind of color of the philosopher's room. Yeah.
Third time attempting to beat him. Screw charging my attack. I'm just gonna spam the fuck out of it. Seems to work better anyway. Ow, game. I'm gonna beat you, you stupid basilisk. Oh, come on. Now, if I'm dead this time, poison's gonna kill me. Ugh. Holy crap, this is horrible. Fourth time fighting the basilisk. Yeah, I'm fighting the basilisk. Yeah, I'm at the end. He poisons me. If it wasn't for his poison, he would be easy. No, I used it. I figured if I died, I'd get it back, but game says fuck you. Prevent myself from getting poisoned, I could beat him. Die, you demon snake, die! I don't even care, I'm willing to take a little damage if I have to. He's angry! Wow, now he's extremely hard to hit. Die! Die, basilisk! Die! Burn! And I bait him! Harry! Oh, Harry! It was me, but I swear, I didn't mean to. Riddle made me. He took me over, and how did you kill that thing? Where's Riddle? It's alright, Riddle's finished. Look, him and the basilisk. Yes, die. Ginny, you're alive. I don't believe it. Back in the Great Hall, Harry told them everything that had happened from how Lord Voldemort had enchanted Ginny Weasley through the diary right up to the battle against the basilisk. And so, thanks to Harry, the Chamber of Secrets was closed once again. Everyone who had been petrified returned to normal, and the students of Hogwarts were treated to the most spectacular feast they had ever eaten. Hagrid was soon reinstated as a groundskeeper, while Draco Malfoy no longer strutted around the school as though he owned the place. Well, guys, I beat it. After counting up the house points for the year, Professor Dumbledore announced that Gryffindor had won the house cup. And I won the house cup. Sweet.
Lucky.
All right. Alright, guys, well, you have just seen the playthrough of Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets for the Game Boy Advance. I didn't do an incredible playthrough, and I definitely didn't get all of the tomato beans, but I don't remember everything. I did do all of the bean challenges, and I got a good amount of cards, not a lot of them, but you know what? I'll keep this file, and if anyone's interested in actually seeing how to get all the cards and how to get all the jelly beans, tell me in a comment, and I will post some extra videos on getting the rest of the stuff. That could be an extra little thing towards this Let's Play. If not, then I guess I can call this Let's Play finished. Maybe, if the credits ever stop. I didn't do a great run. I died quite a few times, and I died 5 times against the basilisk. But I still consider this a pretty good run through. And I'm still missing a spell.
I've missed a ton of spells.
I wonder what the last spell was. It's gotta be an unlocked spell or something, because there's 3 or 4 chests in the game I couldn't get to because they were locked, and there's a ton of bonus rooms I couldn't get into. Oh no, maybe those bonus rooms unlock now. Sweet. Well guys, I'm done with the game. So I hope you enjoyed this Let's Play. I really enjoyed doing it as a tribute to the Harry Potter series. So I posted a question on our Facebook page, and it asks which Let's Plays you'd like to see next. So, because we want to continue some of our old ones. So, anyone that watches these and is interested in letting us know what you want to see, go to our Facebook page and leave us a comment, or you can leave us a comment in the, of course, on YouTube, on the video. All right, guys. I hope you enjoyed watching, and we'll see you next time.